Okay, the next question is, if k is positive real number and a is equal to 2k, any given matrix with order 3 cross 3 and b is other matrix of order 3 cross 3, if adjoint determinant adjoint of a plus determinant adjoint of b is equal to 10 to the power 6, then what is the value of k? This is my question. Given that a is equal to 2k minus 1, 2 on root k minus 2 on root k, 2 on root k, 1, 2k, 2 on root k minus 2k, 1. Similarly, b 0, 2k minus 1 on root k, 1 minus 2k, minus on root k, 0, 2 on root k, 2 on root k and 0. Okay? Given that b is a skew symmetric matrix and we know that any square matrix is known as skew symmetric matrix if b is equal to minus b transpose, and the diagonal entry of skew symmetric matrix is always 0, so that b is skew symmetric matrix. Okay, means that b is equal to minus b transpose. Taking determinant both sides, so that determinant of b is equal to minus determinant of b transpose. We know that determinant of b is always determinant of b transpose. By using this property or by using determinant of b transpose is equal to determinant of b, okay, this is equal to determinant of b is equal to minus determinant of b, okay, and we know that again we know that determinant of k into a is equal to k with the power n into determinant of a, where n is order of matrix and k is any number, then by using this property, determinant of b is equal to determinant of minus 1 into determinant of b, okay, so that determinant of b is equal to minus 1 with power 3 into determinant of b, because the order of given matrix is 3, so that determinant of b is equal to, this is equal to minus 1 into determinant of b, this is equal to determinant of b is equal to minus determinant of b, implies that 2 into determinant of b plus determinant of b is equal to 0, means that 2 into determinant of b is equal to 0. This is the product of any two non-zero quantity and which is equal to 0, so that 2 not is equal to 0 but determinant of b is equal to 0, means that determinant of b is equal to 0. And please listen carefully my statement. If any given matrix is skew symmetric matrix and the order of skew symmetric matrix is odd, then the determinant of skew symmetric matrix with odd order is always 0. I am repeating. If any given matrix is skew symmetric matrix with odd order, then the determinant of this matrix is always 0. So that determinant of b is equal to 0, and we know that if the determinant of b is equal to 0, then determinant of adjoint of b is always 0. I am repeating, if the determinant of any matrix is 0, then the determinant of its disjoint is always 0. So that determinant of adjoint of B is 0. Now, I am calculating determinant of A. Okay, A is equal to 2k minus 1, 2 under root k minus 2 under root k, 2 under root k, 1, 2k, 2 under root k minus 2k, 2 under root k minus 2k and minus 1. Taking determinant both sides, so that determinant of A is equal to determinant of this matrix is equal to determinant of 2k minus 1, 2 under root k minus 2 under root k, 2 under root k, 1, 2k, 2 under root k minus 2k and minus 1. Okay, so that by using R2 plus R3 is equal to R3, or by using row transformation, so that determinant of A is equal to determinant of 2k minus 1 as it is, 2 under root k as it is, 2 under root k as it is, this is this plus this, 2 under root k as it is, 1 as it is minus 2k, this plus this is equal to 0, this plus this 1 plus 2k, this plus this minus 1 minus 2k. Okay, now determinant of A is equal to determinant of 2k minus 1, 2 under root k, 2 under root k, this is 2 under root k, 1 minus 2k, this is 0, 1 plus 2k minus 1 plus 2k, complete determinant. Okay, I am taking common so that determinant of A is equal to taking common 1 plus 2k into determinant of 2k minus 1, 2 under root k, 2 under root k, 2 under root k, 1 minus 2k, this is 0, this is 1, this is minus 1. By using C2 plus C3, okay, C2 plus C3 is equal to C2, okay, so that determinant of A is equal to C1 as it is, 2k minus 1, 2 under root k, 0, this plus this, 4 under root k, this plus this, 1 minus 2k, this plus this, 0, this is 2 under root k minus 2k and minus 1. Okay, add into into 2k plus 1, so that determinant of A is equal to 2k plus 1 into I am expanding by R3. This is 0, this is 0, this is my 0 into by deleting this row and this column 4k 1 minus 2k 2 under root k minus 2k minus 0 into by deleting this row and this column 2k minus 1 2 under root k and minus 2k plus minus plus minus 1 plus into minus 1 into by deleting this row and this column remaining entry is 2k minus 1 2 under root k 4 under root k 1 minus 2k. Okay, so that determinant of A is equal to 2k plus 1 into this is 0, this is 0, this is minus 1 into this 2k minus 1 into 1 minus 2k minus 4 into 2 8 k and root k into and root k means 8k. So that determinant of A is equal to 2k plus 1 into minus 1 into one minus 2k minus 8k. Okay, I am multiplying this number. So that determinant of A is equal to 2k plus 1 into 2k minus 1. I am taking minus 1 common. Okay, I am taking minus 1 common. Minus 1 into 2k minus 1. Minus 1 minus 8k, this is equal to plus. Okay, or I am using other method, please don't care. Determinant of A is equal to 2k plus 1 into minus sign 2k minus 1 into 1 minus 2k and minus 8k. Okay, so that determinant of A is equal to 2k plus 1 into 4k square plus 2k minus 4k square 2k minus 4k square minus 1 plus 2k minus 8k. Okay, so that determinant of A is equal to 2k plus 1 minus 2k plus फोर के स्क्वायर प्लस वन माइनस टू के एड प्लस एट के. ओके सो दैट डिटरमिनेंट ऑफ दे इज इक्वल टू टू के प्लस वन इन टू दिस इज माइनस फोर के फोर के प्लस फोर के स्क्वायर प्लस वन. ओके सो दैट डिटरमिनेंट ऑफ ए इज इक्वल टू टू के प्लस वन इन टू दिस इज टू के प्लस वन कंप्लीट स्क्वायर. ओके फोर के स्क्वायर प्लस वन प्लस फोर के. सो दैट डिटरमिनेंट ऑफ ए इज इक्वल टू 2k plus 1 with power 3. Okay. Now, any doubt? No. So that determinant of A is equal to 2k plus 1 with power 3 and determinant of B is equal to 0. Now adjoint of determinant adjoint of A is equal to we know that determinant of A with power n minus 1. Similarly determinant of adjoint of B is equal to determinant of B with power n minus 1. Where n is the order of matrix, order of given matrix, then determinant adjoint of A is equal to determinant of A. Determinant of A means that 2k plus 1 with power 3 into n minus 1, order of A is 3, 3 minus 1 plus determinant adjoint of B is 0. Okay, and determinant adjoint of A plus determinant adjoint of B is given by 10 to the power 6 because I am calculating determinant of B is equal to 0 and we know very well if the determinant of B is equal to 0 then the determinant of its disjoint is always 0. So that determinant adjoint of A is equal to 2k plus 1 power 3 into 2 plus 0 is equal to 10 to the power 6 means that 2k plus 1 with power 6 is equal to 10 to the power 6 means that 2k plus 1 is equal to 10 by using the index property. Okay, so that 2k is equal to 10 minus 1, 2k is equal to 2k is equal to 9 and k is equal to 9 upon 2 means that k is equal to 4.5. okay, and if k is any positive real number, so that the k is any positive real number which is equal to 4.5, and this is the required answer. If you have any doubt or you have any problem, you can ask me directly. Okay, note kar lo bachcho. Next question dekhte hain. Next, क्वेश्चन नंबर टू, इफ ए इज एनी मैट्रिक्स ऑफ ऑर्डर 3×3 एंड पी इज इक्वल टू 1, 1, 2 अल्फा 3, 4 अल्फा 3 and 4 3, 3, 4 I am repeating, A is any matrix of order 3×3, P is other matrix with the entry 1, 1, 2, alpha 3, 4, 3, 3, 4, okay, and P is the adjoint matrix of A, P is the adjoint matrix of A, and given that determinant of A is equal to 4, then what is the value of alpha? Okay, I am repeating question. If A is any matrix with order 3×3 and P is the matrix which is the adjoint matrix of A, okay, and given that determinant of A is equal to 4, what is the possible value of alpha? We know that by adjoint property of matrix, determinant adjoint of A is equal to determinant of A with power n minus 1. I am repeating, determinant adjoint of A is equal to determinant of A with power n minus 1, okay, and adjoint of A is equal to given matrix P. I am repeating, P is the adjoint of matrix A, okay, so that adjoint of A is equal to given matrix P, and the determinant of adjoint of A is equal to determinant of P, given that adjoint of A is equal to P, so that determinant of adjoint of A is equal to determinant of P, okay, by using this condition, determinant of P is equal to determinant of A with power n minus 1. I am repeating, we know that this is the basic property of adjoint matrix. Determinant of adjoint of A is equal to determinant of A with n minus 1, with power n minus 1, and n is the order of matrix. Given that adjoint of A is equal to P, given that P is the adjoint matrix of A, so that adjoint of A matrix is equal to P matrix. Taking determinant, adjoint of A is equal to determinant of P, and by using this property in this equation or in result A, so that determinant of P is equal to determinant of A with power n minus 1, okay, so that determinant of P is equal to, given that determinant of A is equal to 4, so that 4 with power n minus 1, order of A is 3, given that n is equal to 3 with power 3 minus 1, means that determinant of P is equal to 4 with power 2, means determinant of P is equal to 16. Now I am calculating determinant of P is equal to, so that determinant of P is equal to 16. Now determinant of P is equal to 1 into, by deleting this row and this column, 1 into 3 3 4 4 minus alpha into, by deleting second column and first row, 1 2 3 4 plus 3 into, by deleting this column and this row, 1 3 2 4. Okay, so that determinant of P is equal to 1 into 12 minus 12 minus alpha into 4 minus 6 plus 3 into 4 minus 6. Okay, so that determinant of P is equal to minus alpha minus 2 plus minus 6. Okay, so that next step. So that determinant of P is equal to minus alpha minus 2, means that alpha into 2, 2 alpha minus minus 2 into 3 minus 6. But determinant of P is equal to 16, so that 16 is equal to 2 alpha minus 6, or 2 alpha is equal to 16 plus 6, 2 alpha is equal to 22, alpha is equal to 22 upon 2, means that alpha is equal to 22 upon 2 is equal to 11. Okay, this is, so that the value of alpha is equal to 11. This is the required answer. Okay, I will discuss next question in next part of the lecture. Okay, so bacho, please, my name is Zakir Hussain and the name of my channel is Mathematician Wings. So I am requested to you, please like my videos and subscribe my channel. Okay, please subscribe my channel if you want for the notification.